Hello and welcome to my video, lesson 2.5 and 2.6, combinations. So, if you haven't yet, make sure you've watched the previous videos as we go through permutations, and they are related, although also at the same time, give very different values. So, previously we looked at permutations. Here is an example equation for that. So, basically, the n in this is the total number of items . Okay, r is the number of times that you choose, so let's say decisions. Okay. So if we don't know the order, okay, so if we do know the order, this is what we use, permutations. But now if we don't know the order, what we have to do is we have to use combinations. Combinations does not care about the order. For example, scoops of ice cream in a bowl, who cares which scoop was taken first? It doesn't really matter. All we care about is the types of scoops. Or if you talk about the bills in your wallet, you have 5 bills in your wallet. Well, all that matters is the type of bill. Are they $100 bills or are they $5 bills? We don't care about the order that they are in your wallet. So what we have to do is just take that permutation value and divide by a r factorial. So if we do that, just another way to write that is putting an r factorial right in there. So what that does is it divides by the number of decisions and then that factorial of that. So every time basically it iterates and gets rid of more and more depending on how many decisions you have to make. Okay, so going by Elon Musk's naming scheme for his kids, the only limitations are that each of the characters is one of 26 letters, 10 numbers, one of 32 special characters, or a one of 6 phonetic letters. I'm going to actually change B a little bit. But for A, if we require one of each, how many possible versions can there be? So if it's just one of each, we can talk about our letters, we can talk about our numbers, we can talk about our special characters, we can talk about phonetic characters. So one of each is 26 times 10 times 32 times 6. And so this is just a fundamental counting principle. Okay, but what if, actually I'm going to just change this quite a bit here. Okay, so normally what we do with the permutation version of this is we just add up all these numbers. So maybe I'll just do that right here, 26 plus 10 plus 32 plus 6 is 30, 40, 4, 74. Okay, so we'd go 74 times 73 times 72 times 71. Okay, so this would be the same thing as writing n factorial, which is 74 factorial over 70 n factorial, which is 74 minus 70, or sorry, minus 4, sorry. Okay, which is like 74 factorial over 70 factorial. This is the permutation question, or permutation version of this question. But if we do not care about the order, we have to take a look over here and notice that we have to divide by another r factorial. So it is, if it's a combination question, 74 4, then we go 74 over 4 factorial, 70 factorial. Okay, so let me just plug that into my calculator. Oh, you know what? It can't do that. You know why? It gives you a calculator error because you're going to have to cancel out some of this stuff on your own. So this factorial number and this factorial number are too big. So this is actually a good thing that I'm showing this to you. So sometimes our values can be too big. So what we need to do is these two can cancel down to just that. And then we can go 4, 3, 2, and I mean times 1, but we don't care about that. So let's change my value to 74 times 73 times 72 times 71. So now we can do something that our calculator can't, which is pretty fun. I mean, fun for me. Hopefully, it's fun for you. So this whole thing, even though our calculator gives us an error, if we plugged in the original, but now we can get this. So 1,150,626 different possible version, different versions of the name. Now, this is if we don't care about the order. Okay, so pretty weird stuff, honestly. It's pretty weird. It definitely is. Let's take a look at another situation. Okay, so here, Mr. Drigger really loves Blaze Pizza. The thing about Blaze is that there are so many choices. Dough has 5 choices, sauce has 6 choices, cheese has 9, meats has 6, veggies, finishes. So again, if you were doing fundamental accounting principle, we would just go 5, 6, 9, 6, 17, 15, and just go do, 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 and get our answer. Okay, nice and simple. Okay, but actually, again, to make this a proper combinations question. Okay, so making this more of a combination question. Before it was permutation, which is fine, but not really what we're looking for. I guess I could solve it anyway for you guys. 5 times 6 times 9 times 6 times 17 times 15 is 4 million, no, 4, 1, 3, 100. So this is how many permutations there are. But now, if we're only choosing 4 items, but not including the dough or finishes, so our first item is chosen, 3, 4, and then our last item is chosen, right? We don't care about the order, right? Whatever that we're gonna choose, the sauce, the cheese, the meats, the veggies, it doesn't really matter the order of these things, right? But we don't want a loop, right? We don't want to use two sauces. That's kind of weird. So we're gonna use or we don't want to use the same sauce twice. I guess we could use two sauces. So we're gonna add all these different choices together. So 6 plus 9 plus 6 plus 17 is 38. Okay, so 38 choices, 37 choices, 36 choices, 35 choices. Okay, which is nice, but really doesn't actually give us the real answer because that would be, we'd multiply these if it were a permutation question, which it is not. But this does help us get an idea of the type of question here. Is 38 choose 4? There are 38 items, we're choosing 4 of them. Okay, so 38 factorial over r factorial, which is 4 factorial, over 34, which is 38 minus 4 factorial. And now I think 38 factorial is going to be too big of a number for my calculator. Oh no, it can do it. Okay, so 38 factorial over 4 factorial times 34 factorial. And my calculator can do it this time. It's not quite too big. And so our answer is that there are 73,000 possible combinations, with only choosing four things out of the sauces, cheeses, meats, and veggies. Okay, so this is really just using our combination formula in a few different situations. You just have to get used to recognizing when it actually requires it. But basically, the main point here is we do not care about the order for combinations. So we use this formula here. All right. I hope this video helped you understand combinations a little bit better. Good luck.